Hi friends, I am Dr. Pratap Singh Rathore. I have done MD in pharmacy medicine and today we will discuss about medical legal aspects of death. In medical legal aspects of death, we will discuss about death and IPC, disposal of the body, tissue and organ transplantation, legal presumption of death, questions of presumption of survivorship and issuing of medical certification of cause of death. Coming to one by one, death and IPC. Section 46 of Indian Penal Code states the fact that the word death denotes death of a human being unless the contrary appears from this context. So anywhere it is suggests that it means that death of a human being, unless otherwise it is suggested. Dispose of the body. Immediately after somatic death, that is brain death, rarely spontaneous movements of hand or feet may be observed in the cadaver on the funeral pyre, creating an impression that the person is not actually dead and the disposal is premature. This happens because of molecular death, which takes place usually after 2 hours of death. And during that period, muscle cells are usually still alive. And during that period, sometimes muscle twitching may be seen and family members may think that person is still alive. And this may lead to uproar and may also lead to legal implications to doctor. Tissue and organ transplantation. Viability of transplantable tissues and organs falls sharply after somatic death. A liver must be removed within 15 minutes, kidney within 45 minutes, and heart within an hour. So, after death is the, after the person is confirmed brain death, then only the person can be the person can donate his organs. The family members can use the person's organs for transplantation. And this must be removed within 15 minutes for liver, kidney within 45 minutes, and heart within hour for transplantation. Legal presumption of death. Under Section 107 and 108 Indian Evidence Act, Indian law presumes that if a person is proved to have been alive within 30 years, the law presumes that he is alive. Unless it is proved that person has not been heard for the 7 years by those who would naturally have heard of him, if he had been alive, in which case the law presumes that he is dead. So Section 107 and 108 of Indian Evidence Act tells that if the person is seen alive within 30 years, then he is alive. But within 7 years, if he has not been heard from anyone who from which he naturally will be heard, then the law presumes that he is dead. Question of presumption of survivorship. When two or more persons die at the almost same time or by a common accident, the question may arise who survived the longest. And if no direct evidence on this point is available, the question becomes one of presumption of survivorship. This happens mainly because of in case of property disputes where two sons were died at the same time in a common disaster. So the question arises whether the elder or younger survived the longest. This again depends on the postmortem report done by the doctors, and they will tell whether the person who survived the longest in survivorship. Issuing cause of death certificate. Before issuing, the doctor must confirm the person is dead, then only he should issue the MCCD, that is medical certification cause of death. MCCD is issued in the standard format of Form 4 and Form 4A. Form 4A for Form 4 for institutional death, Form 4A for non-institutional death. MCCD can be used by relatives to get death certificate. And also MCCD is useful for statistics purposes. The part of MCCD given to the family members, they can take to register office, and where from there they can get the death certificate. These are my references. Thank you.